"Courage," he said, and pointed toward the land. "This mounting wave will roll us shoreward soon." In the afternoon, they came unto a land in which it seemed always afternoon. All round the coast, the languid air did swoon, breathing like one that hath a weary dream. Full-faced above the valley stood the moon, and like a downward smoke, the slender stream along the cliff to fall and pause and fall did seem. A land of streams. Some like a downward smoke, slow-dropping veils of thinnest lawn did go, and some through wavering lights and shadows broke, rolling a slumberous sheet of foam below. They saw the gleaming river seaward flow from the inner land. Far off, three mountaintops, three silent pinnacles of aged snow, stood sunset-flushed and dewed with showery drops. Up clomb the shadowy pine above the woven copse. The charmed sunset lingered low adown in the red west. Through mountain clefts the dale was seen far inland, and the yellow down, bordered with palm, and many a winding vale and meadow set with slender galangale. Land where all things always seemed the same. And round about the keel, with faces pale, dark faces pale against that rosy flame, the mild-eyed melancholy lotus-eaters came. Branches they bore of that enchanted stem, laden with flower and fruit, whereof they gave to each. Whoso did receive of them and taste, to him the gushing of the wave far, far away did seem to mourn and rave on alien shores. And if his fellows spake, his voice was thin as voices from the grave, and deep asleep he seemed, yet all awake, and music in his ears his beating heart did make. They sat them down upon the yellow sand between the sun and moon upon the shore. And sweet it was to dream of fatherland, of child and wife and slave. But evermore, most weary seemed the sea, weary the oar, weary the wandering fields of barren foam. And someone said, "We will return no more." And all at once they sang, "Our island home is far beyond the wave. We will no longer roam."